Good morning, children. Let us begin with Standard 4 English Grammar, Unit 15, the article. So read the following sentences. Your first one is, I saw a dog, a cow, and a horse. Second is, this is the dog I saw. And your third sentence is, have you an umbrella with you? So from the above sentences, you will see that a or an does not point out any one definite person or thing, but the points out the particular person or thing. So in the first sentence, it was, I saw a dog, a cow, and a horse. So these a and an, they are not pointing out to certain thing or a person. So we are just randomly talking about any dog or any cow or any horse. But in the second person, with second sentence, when we say, this is the dog I saw, so you are pointing out to a particular dog and showing that this is the dog that we were talking about. So the word a and an is called the indefinite article. So these are called as articles. And what are these a, an, and the? A and an, we know they are vowels. And with the, we say that they are articles. So in vowels a and an, we say that they are indefinite article. Why indefinite? Because it does not point out to any one definite person or thing. And the word the is called a definite article. Why? Because it points out some particular person or thing. When we are pointing out and talking about any particular person or thing, we use the. And these are the two types of articles. That is indefinite article and the definite article. And a and an, we say they are indefinite articles. And the, we say it is a definite article. So now let us learn that where we need to use a, an, and the. So things we cannot count, we say they are uncountable. Uncountable means the things that we cannot count. Take an indefinite article, and usually no plurals. Example, for example, ink, water, milk, wood, flour, meat, sugar, music, smoke, rain, air, electricity. Remember that only countable nouns take a or an. Now, uncountable nouns do not take an a or an before it. We never write a ink, a water. These are all uncountable nouns. Wood, sugar, air, you cannot count them. So we do not use any article before it. But if things that can be counted, articles that can be counted, like books, pencils, pens, and egg, so we use an article before it. If it is only one in the singular, we can use a or an to show that it is only one. So we make a cake. We make one cake with flour, sugar, milk, and an egg. Egg is countable, so we have used an before it. But flour, sugar, and milk, they are uncountable, so we did not use any article before it. An apple means one apple grows on a tree. So we are talking about an apple, that an apple grows on a tree. So both we have used a article before it. We make butter and cheese from milk. Now butter cannot be counted, cheese cannot be counted, and milk also cannot be counted. They are uncountable nouns. So we do not use any vowel before it or any article before it. Bread is made from flour, and flour is made from wheat. So here again, bread, flour, and wheat, they are uncountable. So we do not use any article before it. A piano makes music. So piano is a thing which is countable. So we write a, and music is uncountable. So we do not use any a or an before it. So now let us see where do we use a and. Let us see where a is used. Now before a consonant sound as any consonant means the words which are not vowels. We know vowels are A, E, I, O and U. But the remaining alphabets B, C, D, F till Z which are not vowels are consonants. So before any word which begins with a consonant we use a. For example, I saw a boy. B is a consonant, so we use a in walking in the garden. A motor car runs very fast. Motor. M is a consonant, so we are using a. Now remember, before u, which is a vowel and it is pronounced as u, y double o, we use a. For example, a cow is a useful animal. Though this useful U is a vowel, but the pronunciation of this word useful comes like U. So whenever any word starting with U, and when we pronounce that U as U, we write a before it. We do not take it as a vowel. The sound should be when you, the sound of you comes then only we will use an before it. But if the sound of pronunciation of the sound you comes you, alphabet you comes like you, we use a before it. The next one, he is a European. Again e, your e is a vowel, but again the pronunciation of this E is like U, Y double O. So we are using a before it. Though E is a vowel, we do not use an. And also before O, O is a vowel, but if O is pronounced as V, for example, I lost a 1 rupee note. Here O is a vowel, but the pronunciation of this O is done as V. So when it is pronounced as V, any O word starting, it is pronounced V, we will use a before it, though they are vowels. Now, when do we use an? Now that we know that whenever words begin with vowels, we use an before it. So before a vowel sound. I saw an ass grazing in the garden. There is an egg on the plate. Have you an ink pot with you? So all these are vowels. Ass, A, egg, E, ink pot, I. So we are using an before it. Now, before a silent H, now certain words, they begin with an H. But when we pronounce it, we do not pronounce that H. For example, he was an hour late. Hour means ek ghanta. But here, H is silent. Though it begins, the spelling of R is H-O-U-R. But we do not pronounce that H when we say it. So it, the pronunciation comes R and the first letter after H is O, which is a vowel. So we use an before R. Same way, he is an honest man. Honest spelling is H-O-N-E-S-T. But the H is silent and we say honest man. So O is a vowel. So here also we use an before it. So the words with silent H, beginning with silent H, which are not pronounced and has a vowel after it, then we use an before that word. Now when have we to use the definite article the? Now the is used before common nouns when we want to particularize it. means when we are talking about any particular noun, a person or a thing, we use the before it. For example, this is the boy who stood first in the class. So we are pointing out to a certain boy and we are saying that he is that particular boy. So we use the. This is the girl who won the first prize. So we are talking about a particular person, a boy or a girl. So we are writing the definite article, that is the before it. Then the second is before adjectives in the superlative degree. So do you remember that we just finished the comparison of adjectives and I said that in the superlative degree, if the blank has the before it, then we use the superlative degree. So when we are using this third degree of comparison, we always write the before it. For example, he is the cleverest boy in the class. He is the oldest man in the village. So now, if you must have heard, I said the cleverest and the oldest. Why? Because the cleverest, C is a consonant. So the pronunciation of the is the. But in the next, O is a vowel. And the also ends with a vowel, that is E. So when two vowels are together in two words, we pronounce this the as the. So we read it like he is the oldest man in the village. Then your third one, when do we use the? Before the names of rivers and oceans. For example, the Ganga is a sacred river. Why the Ganga? Because we are talking about the particular river name, that is Ganga. The Arabian Sea. Arabian Sea, only one Arabian Sea, and we are talking about that particular sea, so we say the Arabian Sea. Why the again? T-H-E and Arabian A, they are vowels. So here we pronounce it as the Red Sea. So again, a particular sea we are talking about. So we write the Red Sea. Before the names of mountain ranges. Mountain ranges means the name of any mountains, particular mountains. So we use the before it. For example, the Himalayas are covered with snow. Himalayas, we are talking about the particular mountain range. The Alps cannot be easily climbed. Again, it is a name of a mountain, a particular mountain, so we say the Alps. Next, before the name of sacred books. Sacred books means holy books. The Gita is a holy book of the Hindus. The Bible is the holy book of the Christians. So this is a particular name of the book. So we write the before it. Before the names of nations, as the English defeated the French, the Russians defeated the Chinese. So here we are talking about certain nation and the people. So we use the before it to show the particular place. Now we need to learn that where we don't have to write these articles, that is the omission of the article. So the important points are, no article is used before the name of languages. So any languages like Hindi, Gujarati, Marathi, English, we do not use any article. We just write English is taught all over India. Sanskrit is a difficult language. So these are the name of languages and we do not use any article before it. Then no article is used before proper nouns. Proper nouns means the name of a person. Akbar was a wise king. Akbar is a name of a person, a king. Delhi is the capital of India. They are name of places and it is a proper name, a name given to the city or country. Raman lives in Pune. So these all are proper names, names given to certain places. So we do not use the before it. No article is used before abstract and material nouns. Abstract nouns are what children remember, that it shows the feeling, but you cannot see them. And material is the of what something is made, like rubber, plastic, all those. Remember, we have done in the chapter of nouns. So before these nouns, we do not use the. Health is better than wealth. So here health and wealth both are abstract nouns. So we do not use any article. Wisdom is more useful than courage. Again, wisdom and courage are abstract nouns. So we do not use any article. Iron is more useful than gold. Iron and gold, they are material nouns, something made out of. So here also we do not use any article the before them. Now let us do the exercise one. We have to put a or an, and both are written in capital Y because they are the beginning of the word. So your first one is dash ugly animal. U is a vowel, pronunciation is a, so we write an. Second, dash old animal. So an old animal, because O is a vowel. Third, dash ordinary man. Again, an. Why? Because O is a vowel. Fourth one, dash large egg. So, a large egg. Why? Because L is a consonant. Fifth, an empty box. Why an? Because E is a vowel. Sixth one, dash useful animal. So what will come here, children? A. Why? Because U is a vowel, but the pronunciation of U here is U, that is Y double O. So here we need to write a useful animal. Don't see that it is a vowel and you directly write A-N. See the pronunciation of U and then write a or an. Seventh, dash animal and dash insect. So it will come an animal and an insect. Eighth, dash brave man. So a brave man. Ninth, dash happy person. So we write a happy person. Why? This is not a silent H. We pronounce that happy like H. So we write a happy person. And the tenth one, an unhappy person. So now let us do exercise two. We have to fill in the blanks with a, an, or the wherever necessary. So your first one, I saw an ox grazing in the field. Second, there are 12 months in a year. Third, an umbrella is a useful thing. Umbrella starts with U. Now you see the pronunciation of U here, it is um. So here we use an vowel before it, and useful, the pronunciation comes U. So here we use a before it. Fourth, the Germans were defeated by the English. Fifth, the train was an hour late. H is silent and O is pronounced. So we write an hour late. Sixth, he is an honest man. Again, H is silent and O is a vowel after it. So we write an. The seventh sentence, Kamla is an ideal girl. Eighth, the iron box is heavy. So you can write an iron box is heavy or the also. Why? Because we are talking about some particular iron box, so we are using the. Ninth, English is not an easy language. And the last one, my brother lives in dash Punjab. Here we cannot write a Punjab, we cannot write an Punjab, or we cannot write the Punjab. This is a name of a place and it is a proper name. So we do not use any article before it. Let's begin with exercise 3. Now we have to complete this conversation between a father and son by using a, an, or the. So let's begin. The father says, look outside, Arun. The sky is getting dark. Arun says, yes, Papa. It looks as if there is going to be a storm. Then the father says, bring an umbrella for me. I want to go out for a walk. Arun, mother has gone out with the umbrella. Shall I bring a raincoat for you? Father, I will have to change the shoes also. Do you know where my boots are? Arun, they are in the closet. Closet is in the cupboard. I will bring them for you. Father, thank you, Arun. Arun, oh Papa, will you do me a favor? Can you post this card for me? Father, the main post office is round the corner. I will post your card. Arun, thank you very much, Papa. So, I hope children you have understood this chapter of the articles and how we have to use them. So now you need to complete these three exercises very neatly in your English grammar textbook and also learn the definitions of a definite article and an indefinite article which are given in the blocks. So thank you and have a very nice day.